We are now going to have a few lessons in which we will discuss what options you have if you are confronted with a computationally hard problem, because you will probably be unable to avoid such problems altogether. Sometimes you just have to deal with a problem like this if you encounter it. So for this reason, we want to at least briefly talk about possible mitigations. We have mainly focused on decision problems so far, but to discuss these mitigations, it makes more sense to talk about the search or optimization versions of such problems. Now, for decision problems, to say that the problem is NP-complete is an indication for the difficulty of the problem. However, this really only works for decision problems, because the class NP-complete does not contain any non-decision problems, by definition. So the question is, how could we express or give an indication of the difficulty of a problem that is not a decision problem? For this purpose, we introduce NP-hardness. The problem A is NP-hard if every problem in NP reduces to it in polynomial time. It is important that for this reduction we use Cook reductions rather than Karp reductions. This is because Karp reductions only tell us something about the relationship between decision problems. But now A does not necessarily have to be a decision problem anymore. So really Cook reductions is what we need here. The following are examples of NP-hard problems. Finding a minimum vertex cover in a graph is NP-hard. Finding a Hamiltonian cycle in a graph is NP-hard. And the halting problem is also NP-hard. The first two of these are not decision problems. The last one is. And another observation is that NP-hard problems may be much, much harder than anything contained in NP. The halting problem isn't even decidable, yet it's NP-hard. When we were talking about NP-completeness, we also required that the problems are actually contained in NP. For NP-hardness, we have no such requirement. It is for that reason that the class NP-hard can contain problems which are much, much, much harder than anything in NP. When we say that something is NP-complete, it pretty precisely describes what kind of difficulty we think the problem has. When we say it's NP-hard, we give a lower bound for the difficulty, but no real upper bound. In the next video, we will discuss what options you have if you encounter NP-hard optimization problems.